You must be. I have your name written down here. Francis Marshall. Yes, Miss Marshall. Oh, it's Mrs. Marshall. Well, thank you for coming in today. My name is Data Riddle. I am Ebony's homeroom teacher and English teacher. And I wanted to go over some things with you. How come your husband hasn't joined us? Because this is for both parents. Okay, I see. That is perfectly fine. Well, your daughter is doing well in all of her classes. She seems to be really trying in every class that she is attending. However, she's having a little trouble with algebra. And social studies. Yeah, those are the main subjects that she's having a little complications with. So that's one thing I wanted to talk to you about. She needs to bring up her grade for both of those classes because it goes in her portfolio. She will be a senior next year, is that correct? Okay. So, have you ever thought about her having a tutor? Okay. Well, as I said before, she is an excellent, excellent student. She's not disruptive in any class. I will point out to you, if she hasn't talked to you about this, there are some students her age that do not get along with her. But so far she seems to be handling it pretty well. I'm very proud of her. And as so should you. If you excuse me one moment, I am looking for some papers that I wanted to show you of what she is working on. Oh, yes, ma'am. No, she doesn't have to take summer school. Unless she wants to. She can, however, take extracurricular activities. This is while school is in session. It's not really, it can be an after school thing, but it can be also be during school, or it can be summer school. But she is such a good kid, like, I would not recommend summer school for her. But for the extracurricular activities, I would definitely talk to her about that. I have mentioned it to her a time or two, and she says that she will discuss that with you. Yes, she's going to discuss that with you. She didn't say when, so I assume that she'll either discuss it with you tonight or just whenever she feels comfortable. Oh, yes, I would not push it on her whatsoever. I mean, these years in high school, they're pretty tough. I mean, when I was in school, when I was her age, you know, it was pretty tough for me. So I understand, you know, that she's having a little bit of, you know, some complications in some classes. Oh, she wants to take journalism? Well, then she would have to talk to the principal about that. Yes. Oh, yes. She can drop her math class, although I wouldn't recommend that because sometimes you do need math in life. No matter what situation or what job that you have, it's always good to know math. She's pretty good on her money skills, correct? Has she been taught her money skills at all? Okay. Oh, yes. Oh, really? Okay. Oh, sure. Well, you won't have to worry about working with her on that if she's gonna have a tutor. Okay, this is what she has been working on today in math. She didn't quite finish it, but some of the answers She did get correct. And the very last two, she did not get correct. But she's not finished working on this. Well, the reason being. Yeah, the reason being she didn't finish it is because as we were working on it, we had a fire drill. And so that took quite a while, considering we have about 500 students within the whole school. And so, yeah. Oh, she told you about that. Yeah, we've been having fire drills all week for the past 2 weeks. Well, that's because the kids are not doing what they're supposed to be doing when there's a fire drill. I know. She cooperates. Like I said, she's a very, very excellent student. But as far as the rest of the students, I mean, not all students are bad, but most of them, let's say 50 students out of the whole school. Like I said, there's about 400 students, and 50% of them, or at least 50 of them, just don't want to cooperate. And so our principal says that if they do not cooperate, then we're gonna have fire drills until they cooperate. Yes, we've had to deal with that when I was in school. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. All right, let's see. I'm going to give you the tutor's cell phone number. Okay. Well, name and cell phone number. Yes, you can contact her anytime. I will contact her first to let her know that she's going to be working with Ebony. Yes, ma'am. Oh, of course. Right. Yes, I will contact her first. And then from then on, you can contact her and let her know, like, when to come to your house to help Ebony study. Or it doesn't have to be at your house if you are not comfortable with that. It can be anywhere. Library, our library, the public library. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Well, let me write down the number. Okay. Piper Sound. Also wanted to stress to you that she is having some anxiety in her algebra class in social studies. So what I want to offer to you is, have you ever heard of ASMR? You have. Do you understand what it stands for? No? That's okay. Most parents have heard of it but don't know what it stands for. And other parents have never even heard of ASMR. But ASMR stands for Autonomous Sensory Meridian Response, and it just basically, it helps calm a person down. It triggers people's emotions and feelings, like if someone were to hear like this paper move around like I was doing a while ago. Like this. That is a form of ASMR. If something triggers you, it makes you feel relaxed. When you're relaxed, you get a tingly sensation that starts from the top of the head and goes all the way down to your spine. It's like a shivery tingle sensation. It's awesome. So, there are many, many ASMR artists on the internet, such as YouTube and Twitch and a bunch of other places that I can give you a list of where to go to for these sessions. But it's on the internet. So, are you comfortable with your daughter being on the internet? I don't mean like her personally on the internet. I mean searching the web for ASMR and for just her homework in general. Oh, yes. We are on top of all of our students. We stay on them like ugly on a hairy biscuit. Yeah. That's how much we watch them. So I can assure you that we will keep an eye on all of the children when it comes to searching the internet. Okay. We don't do anything drastic such as that without consulting the parents first. That's what we believe. We believe in contacting parents first before we like make a drastic decision on what we teach and what we use to teach the students. Well, thank you. I'm glad you commend us on that. That is very much appreciated. Here is the number to the tutor. I'm going to just lay that right there for you. Do you have any questions or concerns or anything like that? I wonder. I'll have to check on that, and then I will let you know. Oh, yes, ma'am. Yes, we do ASMR in our classes before class starts. Just to motivate the children and get them relaxed enough. Not enough to sleep in class. I mean, that's a big no-no. But we want them to feel relaxed and stress-free. So, may I show you the things that we do in our class? Okay. As I said, I'm gonna borrow the the tutor's note or phone number for a minute. We use sounds. Isn't that nice? Oops, I didn't mean to bump you, ma'am. Doesn't that sound beautiful? It sure does. Okay, I'm gonna straighten this paper out for you. And I'm gonna give it back to you. In another trigger that we use is we use pens that have those backs that you click like this. I'll just put that close to your ear. And so, there is slow sounds or tapping sounds, and then there's fast. Most of the students like the aggressive clicking noise of pens, and the rest of the students, or I should say other students, like it nice and slow, or on a medium level. Did you enjoy that? Yeah. We also do hand sounds. is probably too low of a sound as far as hands go, but it does work. Once again, do you have any questions or concerns? Well, then I guess we are done with this meeting. Thank you so much for coming in, and it was a pleasure to meet you. All right. You take care.